Now Hindu kingdom of Vijayanagar. During the Sultanate periods, there were attempts to establish authority over South India. Alauddin Khilji was the first ruler to launch an attack, and he carried away enormous wealth from Devgiri. Subsequently, Malik Kafur destroyed the kingdom of Warangal. The condition of South India worsened during the time of Muhammad Tughlaq. Simultaneously, the Hindu Empire of Vijayanagar and the Bahmani Sultanate were also established in South India. After the defeat of the ruler of Warangal, the two brothers of the Jadav clan, Harihara and Bakka, established the Vijayanagar kingdom. Under the inspiration of Swami Vidyanarayan, the Vijayanagar kingdom was established in the south of the Tungabhadra River in 1336 CE. Within a short period of 8 years, the kingdom was extended from the river Tungabhadra to Kanyakumari. Bakka ascended the throne after the death of Harihara. His descendants being weak, a new dynasty came to power. Krishna Deva Raya was a powerful ruler of this dynasty. Krishna Deva Raya's rule flourished in South India. He had good relations with the Europeans and was a lover of art and literature. He constructed canals in South India with the help of an engineer called Yomke. Foreign travelers who visited Vijayanagar have appreciated its grandeur. There were grand temples and forts in the kingdom. This glorious state was destroyed in the Battle of Talikota. You can see the picture of Krishna Deva Raya and the Vijayanagar. Means, in the period of Muhammad Tughlaq, two states were founded, that is Hindu Empire of Vijayanagar in south and Bahmani state of Sultan Hasan. Seeking inspiration from Vidyanarayan Swami, in 1336 AD, two brothers of Jadav lineage, Hariharai and Bakkarai, founded Vijayanagar on the south bank of the river Tungabhadra. In this lineage, there exists a powerful king named Krishna Deva Raya. He was fond of education and literature. In Vijayanagar, there were gorgeous temples and artistic forts. The gorgeous, wealthy Vijayanagar had its fall in the Battle of Talikot. The Bahmani Sultanate. The Amirs in the Deccan rebelled. Hasan of the efficient Amirs became the Sultan of founded the Bahmani Sultanate. There, Muhammad Gawan was a capable minister of an efficient administrator of the Bahmani Sultanate. He won many territories and extended the boundaries of the Bahmani kingdom. The power of Bahmani Sultanate weakened after his death. There were frequent conflicts between the Vijayanagar and Bahmani kingdoms. After the downfalls of the Bahmani Sultanate, many of his provinces became independent. Among these, the five provinces of Bijapur, Ahmednagar, Golconda, Berar, and Bidar became established independent kingdoms. Means there had been an intelligent wazir, prime minister named Muhammad Gawan, in Bahmani state. He expanded Bahmani state, winning a number of provinces. At the fall of Bahmani state, out of them, five independent states came to existence: Bijapur, Ahmednagar, Golconda, Warad, and Bidar. End of Delhi Sultanate. Firoz Shah Tughlaq ascended the throne after Muhammad Tughlaq. However, from that time onwards, the Delhi Sultan began to weaken. The region of the Tughlaq dynasty also witnessed the invasion of plunder of Delhi by Timur.